Check out this wooden flask. Turned on multiple axes, it holds liquids and is food safe. Using a simple technique with tools every woodturner have in their shop, I will show you step by step how to make this cool flask. Let's get started. I'll start off by turning the shape of the flask on the vertical axis. As you might have guessed, the lighter wood is regular construction lumber that will be completely removed later in the process. As I turn the shape of the flask, it is crucial to make the container as spherical as possible. You'll see why later in the process. When I have the container close to spherical, I'll work on the spout and the bottom. Time to switch axes and remove the sacrificial construction lumber. This process consists of making tenons and dowels to attach the flask to the chuck on both sides and removing wood till you have a walnut container with openings on both sides. I'm exercising special care not to snag the neck of the flask with my tool, or worse, my hand. I'm removing wood to a little beyond the center of the flask from one side. Then I flip the piece over and work from the other side. I'm using olive tree wood for the decorative sides. The choice of material is not without meaning, as the flask will hold olive oil on my kitchen countertop. The chuck allows me to form the inside of the panels first, then the outside when attached to the container. This is the moment I know if I did a good job on making the container spherical. If it's not near perfect, the two pieces will not align. I was a bit worried, but this is looking great. I was making sure not to glue on the first panel, as this will have to come off when making the second panel. Now I just remove the first panel and repeat the process. It's time to treat the flask and make it suitable to contain liquids. For this, I'm using epoxy. I said in the beginning of the video that this is food safe. There will certainly be, and I welcome it, a discussion in the comments about the validity of this claim. The manufacturer of this epoxy states on their website that they recommend the product to finish wooden cups to hold liquids, like coffee, but in the same paragraph explains that the product is not certified food safe. So I will moderate my claim with the same reservation. I'm applying two coats of epoxy, using the final coat to attach the second panel to the container. And there you have it, a decorative flask that can actually hold liquids. I had a lot of fun making this, and as always, I'm glad to share it with you. I hope you enjoy this project and come back for the next one.